Hello students, welcome to Saurav sir classes. Today we are going to do some probability sums and the sum is displayed over here. So let A1, A2, dot 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 till AN be n independent events which the probability of occurrence of the event AI is given by probability of AI equals to this. So this is very important, the probability of occurrence of the event A1, A2 or AN, it is given by probability of AI is given by 1 minus 1 by alpha to the power I, where alpha is greater than 1 and I is ranging from 1 till n. So the question is, then the probability that at least one of the events occur is, so we have to find out the probability that at least one of the event occur is. So the probability of occurring at least one event is given by probability of at least one event is given by 1 minus probability of occurring of none. Now the probability of non-occurrence of AI is given by 1 minus probability of AI, because probability of AI is the occurrence of the event AI. So non-occurrence of AI we have to find out. So it will be given by 1 minus probability of AI. So this can be written as 1 minus probability of AI is given as 1 minus 1 by alpha to the power I. So this can be written as 1 by alpha to the power I. Therefore now we can find out the probability of occurring none of AIs equal to 1 by alpha 1 into 1 by alpha square into 1 by alpha cube till 1 by alpha to the power n, which can again be rewritten as 1 by alpha to the power 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus dot dot till n, which can again be written as 1 by alpha to the power n into n plus 1 by 2. So now this value which we have got over here, this we are going to put over here. So probability of at least one event is given by 1 minus 1 by, because AIs we have got this, so it will be 1 minus 1 by AI's alpha I's. So it will be alpha to the power n into n plus 1 by 2. Hence this is the required answer. So option B is correct. Sorry, option A is correct. Thank you for watching the video.